فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الإمام ابن القيم رحمه الله سرني كتاب الوابل، وابل الصيب من كلمة طيب. إسيس فإن العارف سائر إلى الله تعالى بين هذين الجناحين لا يمكن أن يسير إلا بهما، فمتى فات واحد منهما فهو كالطير الذي فقد أحد جناحيه. The person who knows Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is striving and who is moving towards Allah, he moves with two wings. لا يمكنه, it is not possible for her or him, أن يسير إلا بهما. He cannot fly or he cannot reach Allah and know Allah without these two wings. Whenever these two wings, he misses one of them, فمتى فات واحد منهما, whenever he misses one of the two wings, فهو كالطير, he becomes like the bird الذي فقد أحد جناحيه, that lost one of its wings. قال شيخ الإسلام, ابن القيم is saying, شيخ الإسلام said, who does he mean by شيخ الإسلام here? He doesn't mean ابن تيمية, he means أبا إسماعيل الحروي, the author of the book منازل السائرين, which he done the sharh of ابن القيم himself, which he called مدارج السالكين بين منازل إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. ابن القيم, that book منازل the book مدارج السالكين is an explanation of the كتاب منازل السائرين, which is authored by أبو إسماعيل الهروي. So ابن القيم is saying, قال الشيخ الإسلام, meaning أبو إسماعيل الهروي, said العارف يسير إلى الله بين. So I want this principle to be memorized by sisters, brothers and everyone. Wallahi it's important. Wallahi it's important. And when I read this, it directly went towards my heart. It was like a saham, an arrow that was directed at my heart. Because this is a kalam which is very important. He said, Al-Arif, the one who knows Allah. Yasiru ila Allahi, he goes towards Allah. He moves towards Allah in a good way. But in what way? In two ways, remember these two pillars. Barakallah. It's the two wings that he was talking about, Ibn al-Qayyim. What are they? Mushahadatul minnah. To always ponder and observe the blessings that Allah bestowed upon you. The second is وَمُطَالَعَةُ عَيْبِ النَّفْسِ وَالْعَمَلِ. And to always remember the errors and the mistakes in your soul and in your actions. And that is the meaning on this, in the speech of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this hadith narrated by who? Al-Imam al-Bukhari in Kitab Da'awat. He made a whole chapter in أفضل الاستغفار. The best dua for istighfar. The best of those virtuous istighfar forgiveness. Also Imam al-Nasa'i narrated it. Also Ahmad ibn Hanbal narrated in his Musnad, Ibn Abi Shayba in his Musannaf. Bukhari also narrated in his Adab al-Mufrad, Hakim narrated in his Mustadrak, Ibn Hibban in his Sahih, Tabarani in his Mu'jam al-Kabir, Ibn Nasr al-Marwazi, he narrated in Kitab Qiyam al-Layl, Ibn Manda in his Kitab al-Tawheed, Baghawi in Fisharh al-Sunnah, all of them narrated in Tariq Hussein ibn al-Mu'il, and Abdullah ibn Buraida, and Bashir ibn Ka'b, and Shaddad ibn Awsin, radiallahu ta'ala an, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, سيد الاستغفار, the master of all forgiveness, the dua for forgiveness is أن يقول العبد, that the servant says اللهم أنت ربي, oh Allah you are my Lord, لا إله إلا أنت, there's none worthy of worship except you, خلقتني, that you created me, وأنا عبدك, and I'm your servant, وأنا على عهدك, and I'm on your oath, ووعدك ما استطعت, and as much as I can, أعوذ بك من شر, أعوذ بك من شر ما صنعت. I seek refuge in Allah, in you, in the evil in which I do. Now remember this. What were the two pillars that a person strives to Allah and he will reach Allah in a good way? Two pillars. First principle was what? مشاهدات المنة. The second was what? مطالعة عيب النفس والعمل. The first one was to always ponder and observe the good things that Allah has bestowed upon you. The second is that you always also observe and you always ponder on the things that you've done wrong and you regret it and it makes you cry, and your actions as well. This hadith mentions the two. It's in this hadith. The Prophet, what did he say? أبوء لك بنعمتك علي. So you're remembering Allah because of the blessings in which He blessed over you. Do you see the blessings that Allah put on you? What's the second one? وَأَبُوءُ بِذَنْبِ. And remembering and pondering on what? The evil that's in your soul. What did the two bring? What do the two bring? فَمُشَاهَدَةُ الْمِنَّةِ. If the person ponders on the blessings that Allah gives him, تُوْجِبُ لَهُ الْمَحَبَّةِ. It brings and it necessitates love and praise and shukr, you see, to Allah Azza wa Jal. The person who mutala'atu aib an-nafs, who always remembers his errors and mistakes and the things that he does wrong, what does it bring? It brings tujibu dhulla wal inkisar, humiliation towards Allah, putting himself low, repenting to Allah. And not to see himself except a person who's bankrupt. With these two, if you ponder, sisters, if a person always remembers the blessings that Allah put on him, he will start loving Allah. And loving Allah with complete love is one of the pillars of servitude. And if the person ponders upon the mistakes or he or she does, then this brings humiliation. And dhul. And dhul is the second pillar of servitude. So that's why ubudiyyah, servitude, madaruha ala qa'idataini huma asluha. Servitude stands over two pillars that are the fundamental parts of it. Servitude doesn't stand on except those two, which are what? Hubb kamil. Complete love. Wa dhullun tam. And a complete humiliation. Those are the two. And those are the two which come from, complete love comes from pondering on the blessings that Allah blessed on you. This will bring love. And looking at your mistakes and your errors and what you've done will also necessitate complete humiliation. And this is the kalam I benefited from the book of Ibn al-Qayyim. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.